My research looked at the oil price shock in Nigeria and tried to look at these macroeconomic effects on Nigerian economy. 2014 was, a year in which too many things happened. But the most important is the fall in oil price, which is the shock. And for a country that's highly dependent on oil, with about 85% of government revenue coming from oil, that is significant and created a lot of problem. And indeed, many of the states, 36 states plus the federal capital territory, depend on their sources of revenue from this oil. In fact, at the end of every month, that's what you call the federal government allocation to states, where they go and collect money. The gross domestic product, which of course had fallen drastically, and since 2014 had been starting, but by 2016, this year, we recorded for the first time negative growth in gross domestic product and that threw Nigeria into recession. This also was recorded in the second quarter of 2016. So inevitably now, Nigeria is in recession. Secondly, it had affected prices all over. The prices have been soaring very high, between 11 and 14% over the last 6 months. Thirdly, state governments have found it very difficult to pay their emoluments and salaries to staffs, partly because the revenue which they collect from the federal government has fallen due to the fall in oil prices. I mean, that's the main source of revenue. So that has created its own problem. Also, there have been, an increase in non-performing loans. In other words, banks are carrying bad debts on their books. Again, that's understandable because the main source of revenue are the people, and people have not been getting their salaries. They've not been able to pay back, So those are ripple effects of this crisis that we have seen, the shock that happened in the economy. Those are the major ones. The point to take away is this. It shows very clearly now there is need for a rethink on the diversification of the Nigerian economy. In other words, how do we move away from oil and get other sources of revenue? And in trying to identify all these other sources, what are these sources of revenue? That is what my research did, and I tried to identify four or five of them. First is to look at the various sectors of the economy, the agricultural sector. Agriculture had been a very important sector for Nigeria over the years. Before the arrival of oil, it was the major source of revenue. Now we are going back into it to look at agriculture as a source of generating revenue through what we call value-added agriculture, agro-allied industries that can bring in revenue. We are also looking into tax revenue. If you look at tax in Nigeria to GDP, it's the lowest in Africa. We have other countries that, not as rich as Nigeria, that are generating so much revenue. But because of the oil, we just kept that one, at bay. We didn't worry. But now we have to worry about it. So we're talking about income tax. We are also thinking of VAT, value-added tax, as a way of generating more revenue. The third thing is to enhance the value of professionalism. And we have the entertainment industry in Nigeria, which is very important. And I think it's very important that government should pay attention to it. It's called Nollywood. If a lot of focus was paid to it, then Nigeria could generate many billions of dollars every year. People have been talking about the whole idea of generating revenue. My research did point out that it is not only generating revenue that is important. Another one that is important is the need for government to reduce its size, overlapping of functions in Nigeria. And the government has to reduce the size of the bureaucracy. The bureaucracy is overblown. The political senators and all these people, their remuneration is much above the economy that they serve. They become masters of the people. So if we reduce all this waste, if you go out and look for more money, you waste it all the same. And of course, nipping the bud, the issue of corruption, which is the bane of Nigerian economic society. The main important message that people should take home is that we should not be in a state of despair. Indeed, the crisis that has occurred is opening up more opportunities for Nigeria to develop alternative means of income. See what value we can add without reference to oil, and see how whatever resources we make there, we can manage it efficiently by cutting down the size of the bureaucracy, by making sure political leaders are responsible, by making sure we keep watch on whatever remunerations they receive from the economy.